What's up everyone, my name is Leah Yu. Today we are going to talk about Korean cushion compacts again, but today's slightly different because it's going to be a summer edition. So I hope you guys find this video a little bit helpful, especially those of you guys who live in high temperature and high humidity climate. You guys have been requesting this video for ages. Get excited and let's begin. First things first, I want to introduce you guys to the Etude House Real Powder Cushion. And I've been pretty much enjoying wearing this during the summertime and also ever since it was released. At first I was a little bit confused because the formulation itself was very, very new to me. It was very disruptive to this cushion foundation market, and it's not something that you would normally expect from a cushion foundation. It's a liquid to powder formula, so as soon as you apply it on your face, it'll dry down to a pretty much matte, like legit powder finish. So I highly recommend you guys to incorporate using a bronzer or a contour shade to kind of give some definition to your face, color to your face, because it tends to make you look a little bit flat because it doesn't really give you any glow. I super love this foundation because it's highly pigmented, meaning that it will provide almost full coverage with a really lightweight consistency, so it doesn't really feel heavy on your face at all. I found this foundation to be really good with sweat. Like, it didn't really melt down while I was wearing this in Singapore, and Singapore was super humid and hot. It was like almost 38 Celsius and I was like, this heat is really suffocating, but the foundation managed to stay the entire day with a good primer underneath, so I really love this. This has a very strong fragrance and it does linger around throughout the day, so if you're allergic to artificial scents, be aware of that. Next up, we have a very summery looking cushion foundation here. It is the Innisfree Long Wear Waterproof Cushion, and I believe this is their newest addition in their cushion range. I need to point out though, the Innisfree cushion shades, they tend to run slightly lighter and brighter and even wider in terms of the color. Since it claims to be waterproof, the girl from the store like highly recommended me to make sure I double cleanse to remove all the waterproof factors because it can kind of clog on your pores, so just make sure you cleanse thoroughly when you're using the waterproof anything. First impression towards this foundation wasn't really that great because the consistency was a little bit strange to me. It was almost like tacky when you were applying it, and the blending process was a little bit too hard. The cushion puff would stick to my skin and it wouldn't let me blend or swipe the applicator on my face, so it was a little bit confusing. But as soon as you blend it in, it dries down to almost like matte finish and it won't budge at all. It's very smudge proof, it's very waterproof, so it lasts you pretty much the entire day. It will kind of lock everything down and seal everything and won't let anything budge or smudge. However, the coverage for this foundation is not that great. It's super natural. I think this will be suitable for those guys who are looking for a foundation that can just even out their skin tone, just achieve that brighter complexion a little bit, and add some SPF onto their skin. It's perfect for daily wear in high humidity weather because it's pretty much sweat proof. When I work out in this foundation, it pretty much kind of managed to stick on my skin like throughout the entire workout session without budging or smudging or just dropping that really gross foundation sweat. Oil control, sweat control is really, really great with this foundation, and the texture is super lightweight as well. Recommendation number three, we have VDL Expert Metal Cushion Foundation, and I know a lot of you guys have been really anticipating for my review for this foundation. I have been using this for a couple of weeks by now, but nothing really wowed me so far, like, but at the same time, nothing really disappointed me, so I thought it would be a good idea to throw this in here because it does provide a super matte finish that a lot of extremely oily skin will benefit from, but at the same time it's very, very drying for some of the other skin types out there, so you gotta be cautious when you layer this product. It will accentuate like all the dry patches. I do have oily skin, but sometimes I feel like this is a little bit too drying towards the end of the day. But I do have to say though, the metal tip or the metal plate that's inside here, it kind of gives you that, you know, cooling sensation instantly, and it just feels a little bit cleaner and more hygienic than any other cushion compact. So whenever I use this, I always tend to use a very hydrating skincare routine underneath so that it will adhere a little bit better and it doesn't really dry me out. So be cautious of that. Otherwise, it's a great super matte foundation. I've been waiting for this moment to talk about this foundation because this just instantly became one of my favorite cushion foundations of all time, and it is the Lyrikos Marine Collagen Cushion Moisture. It is their newest cushion foundation range, and I just love it. And I really adore this foundation because it does have a very cooling sensation, and also it has like collagen and hyaluronic acid in it, which can benefit your firmness and elasticity on your skin, and it just makes your skin like so damn goddamn better. And I promise you guys, you will love this foundation. It just creates a beautiful film on top of your skin, and it just blurs out everything like imperfections, pores, like fine lines. It doesn't clog into your pores, which is really, really important to me. Like by the end of the day, the foundation still lasts like pretty decently without clogging or clinging around my fine lines and pores. The coverage of this foundation is almost medium to high, and the finish is semi-matte to matte. We have the G-Dragon cushion from Moonshot. It's the micro fit cushion, and as I reviewed this, this is probably the closest cushion foundation that I could find to replace YSL Lip Cushion Encre de Peau, which costs like 71,000 Korean won, which is crazy because it doesn't even give you a spare refill. But I really adore that foundation, and I've been meaning to repurchase it. Refill costs like 41,000 won, and I'm like, really? But then I found this item, and it's way, way more affordable, but it just gives you a very similar finish to the YSL one, and it just provides a beautiful, like, subtle glow on top of your face. It's semi-matte, so probably this is the least matte cushion foundation among all of the cushion foundations that I've introduced you guys today. So if you have more drier skin types and you want to still like try out more semi-matte finish, this will be a perfect foundation for you guys. This is a very natural looking foundation. I've been really enjoying wearing this because you can achieve that really healthier looking complexion, and it provides a decent coverage as well, so nothing to really complain about. I did find this to be not exactly sweat proof though. When I was sweating in the gym wearing this foundation, it didn't really look the best. I don't really think this will be suitable in like really, really high humidity condition, but if you do live in a higher temperature but a drier condition, I feel like this will work perfectly in those type of like summertime. Initially, I was planning to make this video a top 5 cushion recommendation, but then I'm going to just throw 2 more into the list, you know, just because. And the very first one is the Sorasu Perfecting Cushion in Brightening. I actually just ran out of this cushion. I didn't really get the chance to repurchase it yet just because I have like so many other cushion products to go through, and there's like constantly new cushion product that I need to review in the market. So I've been just really occupied with other cushion foundation, but this one is like actually a very beautiful product. This is the most high-end product among all of the foundations that I mentioned today, and this just provides a very like airbrush, natural looking, like youthful looking skin. And I have this on my right side right here, and I'll show the demo. This just provides a beautiful semi-matte finish with a subtle glow on top of your skin. Your skin just becomes like really radiant, really healthy looking, and I feel like this does kind of provide that extra film on top of your skin that just blurs out all the pores and your fine lines. And I highly recommend this product to those of you guys who are kind of feeling a little bit spendy and want to really invest a good cushion compact with a good skincare property in it. And Sorasu is known for their great, amazing natural ingredients that they put in even makeup range. So it has like white magnolia extract and other great extracts like into this little cushion compact. So if you're into that kind of things, I definitely recommend this to you. Last bonus round goes to the Momon Cover Powder Cushion. If you guys have been following me for a while, you might have noticed that I pretty much was going through a lot of cover powder cushions last year. It was one of the very, 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 very first matte cushions out there when every other cushion was claiming to be more moisturizing and dewy and like achieve like glowing skin. But this was the very first like oily skin friendly matte cushion out there, so I was like really happy to discover a matte cushion. Ever since like cushion foundation has evolved, there are so many other great like pigmented, high coverage matte cushion out there. I feel like this was kind of neglected in my makeup collection, but this is like all around an average like okay product. It just provides a medium to high coverage, and also it's super duper matte. I'm wearing this foundation on the left side of my face today. A lot of you guys have been kind of asking me like why I stopped using this. It's just because it feels a little bit like slightly heavier than any other matte cushions I have. Also, I feel like when it kind of wears off by the end of the day, I feel like this does accentuate and clog around the pore area. That's my two cents for this product. I feel like I owe some update and explanation to you guys regarding this product because I was pretty much obsessed up till last year with this product. So yeah, so that's pretty much it for today's entire summer cushion collection or summer edition cushion foundation review. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to click the like button down below. It will help me out a lot. And if you're into this kind of Korean makeup review kind of thing, you can subscribe to my channel down below by hitting that red button down below. And if you want to watch more reviews from my channel, you can click either on this video or this video here. And I'll see you guys very soon with another video. Bye!